So now we are looking at a wind tunnel test, a digital twin simulation in Autodesk CFD. Actually, this is Autodesk Flow, which has less settings and it's faster than the Autodesk CFD Ultimate. That is more a complex data and parametric put in of values such as wind speed, textures of the water surface, temperature, materials like the exoskeleton, the building itself with the glazing, the facades, and so on. So this is more simplified version, but most important here is this, that we are looking in this wind tunnel test first at the categories that we have to set before we can even simulate, and these are coming from a dead load calculations of structural impacts that we have seen before in Autodesk Fusion 360 and robotic structure. Here we're looking at a density of concrete by 2400 kilogram the cubic meter, and the thickness of the concrete slabs are about 60 centimeters. The gravity here is defined by 9.81 meter per square second, and the floor areas, we have here 10 floors, and we are looking here at the wind load calculation, which is here more or less simplified from the so-called Saffir-Simpson Hurricane Wind Scale category 5. Why category 5? Because we are always looking at worst case situations, and category 5 is a worst case situation, and we're dealing here with wind speeds up to 250 or higher kilometer an hour. And if you convert that into meter per second, that would be 72.22 meter per second. In other words, if I look at the wind speed here, this is a typical tropical day in Miami. But if we go up here to 72, which I'm doing right now, you see, it will definitely have an impact. Now let this simulation run. Now here we see a typical situation of an average of 10 meter per second velocity. And on the right side, on the table, on the left side, upper side, you see the legend. Color-coded red stands for the highest velocity and also the highest pressure in PA. And we can clearly see, in terms of the orientation of the buildings, that wherever you have the red color, that means there you have the highest velocity and pressure by this 10 meter per second tropical storm condition or wind condition. Now, if we are taking a wind speed category 5 hurricane and convert that into 72 meter per second, which is translated around 260 kilometers an hour, then you're getting a completely different image of the situation, of course. So I'm going to the wind tunnel, as you see it here, and now we are setting the wind speed to an hurricane 5 category. Then you will see the difference pretty soon. So now we have 1 second. We have the setting on 72. It's solving now the airflow. And voila, here we see an extreme impact on the building structure itself. And interesting is here, that where you see the blue area behind the structure, this is the area where are the lowest eddies and wind currents on the complex, and that gives us an idea in which area we have to probably reinforce the design and twist it and tweak it and optimize it more, so it's more aerodynamic. And then we can also go into the nodes, into the structure itself or the facade components to do further tests in the detail area, because this is the large scale analysis of the wind speed. And there are different ways to do that. We can also change, for example, the pressure area you see here. We can integrate a track plot that gives us more information about the track coefficients, the track force, all in Newton, and the average. And also interesting here is that we can change the display of the velocity with the speed. And we can see here right now it just jumped back to the average of 10 meter per second, which is the default setting. So I would have to go back here and then go through the hurricane categories 1 to 5 and readjust. So I'm going here to 72 one more time and confirm, and then we will see how this has an impact. And now we have more information about the top of the building, and you see the red square, that's a floor situation where we have a gigantic pressure on the facade. So that gives us an idea how to actually optimize the building itself in this simulation. So these are typical fitness tests that are run throughout the entire design iteration. And we are going back and forth to use this information to update the design in the building information modeling, processing of data, programs, and schedules.